At her book launch Wednesday, former President Gloria Arroyo explains the title of her memoir appeared to be the theme of her political life from the time she was senator to the presidency as a matter of divine providence.
As number 12 winner in 1992, rather than top placer in 1995, I would have been just another re-electionist senator in 1998 and not the winning candidate for vice president. I would not have been the constitutional successor to the presidency in 2001.
Arroyo began writing in detention, and she hopes this book will allow people to better know her.
This is my story, as simply as I could write it, because I want you to know me better as a person.
Arroyo admits it was a mistake to call former Carmelite Commissioner Virgilio Garcilaso back in 2004. The former president describes it as a self-inflicted error and a lapse in judgment. She insists it wasn't to rig the election, as the elections were over when they talked. Some winners had been proclaimed, and her lead over Fernando Poe Jr. was insurmountable. Arroyo lists the reasons why she believes she won fair and square, chief of which was her decision to get Noli de Castro as her vice president to split Poe's voter base, the medical treatment of former Senator Urroco, who split her own voters, rising support for her closer to the election day, endorsements from religious groups, and the much-vaunted administration machinery. Arroyo's book also delved into her tempestuous but ultimately friendly relationship with her predecessor after they won in the 1998 elections on separate tickets and Estrada got her to join his cabinet till Edsa Dos split them apart. But when the shoe was on the other foot, Estrada came to support Arroyo when she was detained by her own successor. Arroyo recalls that Estrada had told her she should have supported him in 2010 so she wouldn't have been persecuted. These days, the two leaders look back at those times in jest. On the other hand, her relationship with former Presidents Cory and Noynoy Aquino never recovered. Cory began as her mentor and cheerleader when she wasn't sure she would be president. The Hello Garci scandal changed all that, because that was when Cory would tell her for the first time she would ask her to resign. Arroyo reveals that until the very end, she had prayed that she and former President Noynoy could move past their difference. As she noted, he avoided her. That one time, they were both in Malacañang when President Duterte assumed office. On the other hand, Rodrigo and Sara Duterte gave Arroyo her fresh start after she was cleared of plunder. For the first time, Arroyo reveals it was the president's daughter who really campaigned to make her speaker back in 2018. Arroyo explained she found vindication in the speakership. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.